Hi everyone, welcome you all. This is Pavan from SDT channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how we can read data from JSON file in Python. Let's get started. So here I have a PyChamp, and which is an editor where we can write our Python programs. And I have just created a new project called JSON project in my PyChamp. And here JSON files is my folder. Inside this folder, I will put one JSON file. Let me just create a new JSON file here. So let me just take any new file and I will name it as employee.json. Now, okay, now it is just created new employee.json file. So in this file, I'm just copying some data. So which contains the first name, last name, and address of the employee. So address again, it is a JSON array and which contains the JSON objects. So first name, last name is the key and values. Address is also another key, which is a JSON array and which contains a JSON object, and each object contains again street, city, and state. Now we'll see how we can read this data from this JSON file. So in Python, we have a default library, which is JSON, which is available with Python. So we can use those, we can use that JSON library. So to do this, let me just create a new Python file. I'll name it as read data from json.py. So in this file, I'm going to write a Python code which will read the data from this JSON employee.json. So first of all, we need to import that library, that is JSON library, which is available in Python. Let's say import JSON. So after that, we need to read a file. So we need to read a file, or we have to open the file. So how to open the file? So that file is already there in my JSON folder, employees.json. This file we have to open. So to open the file, first of all, we need to get the path of this file. So right click on this file and copy relative path. So here I need to use a method called open, and here single quotation specify that location of the file. So JSON file is my folder, /employee.json. This is one parameter, and the second parameter will be the R, means which will open the file in the reading mode. So after opening this file, and I'm referring that file with one variable. Let's say I'm just giving my JSON file. Now this particular statement will open the JSON file. Now from this file, we need to read the data. So here what we have to do is take this file, my JSON file dot read, and now this command will read the data from this file, and I will save the data in my variable called JSON data. So this is the JSON data. Now from this data, we have to parse it. So JSON data is normally in the string format, so we need to parse the data in the JSON format. So for that, what you have to do is we need to parse it. The next statement is parse. So how to parse it? So to parse the JSON data, we need to use a method called JSON package, JSON library, which we have imported, right? So JSON dot, there is a method called loads. So this particular method will parse the JSON data. So let me parse this parameter, and this will parse the JSON data. After parsing, I'm saving that into an object variable. So this is representing the JSON object. Now from this JSON object, the whole file will be considered as a JSON object. And now from this object, we can extract first name, last name, and address fields. Now let me extract them. So to extract those values, what we can do is we need to specify obj, that's my JSON object, of, in the bracket, we have to specify the key. So let me just extract the first name, that's my key, and then specify here. So obj is my JSON object. From that, I'm extracting the first name. And then after extraction, I have converted that into string. And then I just print that one. So let me just use a print method here. So now in this statement, what we have done is from this JSON object, we have extracted the value of the first name, and then converted that into string, and then I'm printing it here. Similarly, we can also print the last name. Get the last name is a key and specify the last name. and we can also print the address, but address is again contains a two elements, right? So that those two elements will be printed here when I say address. Now let us run this code till here. So now we can see this is a first name, this is a last name. Now address is contains a two elements, one element and second element. Again, these two elements are the JSON objects. Now how we can read these elements in the JSON array? I want to extract individual elements, and apart from these elements, I need to extract the specific values. Let's say I want to get the street, I want to get the city or state. So how we can get it? So to get it, what we can do is we need to just write a loop statement. So for example, let us say as soon as I extracted this address, which contains a multiple elements, right? I can save those elements in the Python list. So instead of printing this, what I will do is I will just create one variable of list. So it's a just a list variable equal to obj of address. So what this basically will do is, so from this JSON object, it will extract the address, which contains again JSON objects, will be saved in this list. So now if I print this list, it will print all two items again. So when I run the code, now you can see it is printed exactly the same way. So which contains a two elements. Now, if I want to extract a specific element, this one, or if you want to count how many number of elements, we can write like this. Let's say print list of zero index. When I pass an index, which will give you the first element. And when I pass one, which will give you the second element. This is a second element, this one, right? This is a second element. And if you want to count how many items we have, let's say list dot size or length of list. So which will give you length of list, which will give you exactly how many elements we have in this JSON array. There are two elements we have in this JSON array. Now, this is not our ultimate goal. So we have to read the data from the JSON array. Now, how we can read it? So to read each and individual data from this JSON array, we have to write a loop statement. So let me write one for loop. So for i representing the index. So i in, I'm using a range function, range of, so from range of length of list. So how many elements we have in this list? Those many number of times I want to repeat this loop. So now we need to extract the data. So how we can extract the data? So let's say print. So here we need to write one expression. So I representing the index, the first element and the second element. So here what we have to do is from this list, extract the element, I representing the element. So which will extract this element? This will extract the list of I representing the first element. So the whole element again contains a street, city and state. So I want to extract a street. So here I'll say dot get of, specify the key here. So that is street, right? So then close this. And I will also write some meaningful message here. This is my street. This is my street, comma is a concatenation. And the same way, we will also try to extract city and state. So this is my city, this is my state. Right, so this is my city and this is my state, right? So first it will index will be zero. So from this index zero, that means the first element, it will capture the street, city and state. After completion of one round, second round, I value becomes one and then it will get the another element. So index will start from zero, second time it will become one. So in the first index of I, list of I means again, list of one, street, city and state. So from this element, it will capture individual elements. So before that, I'm just going to print a meaningful message. So here I will say address of, and here I will print I value. I'll print I value, right? Is, I'm just giving some space here so that we will know exactly which element it is. So now save it. Then execute one more time. All right, so now we can see here. So this is a complete array, JSON array, which contains the two elements. So now address of zero is, that means the zero element. So again, if you see here, this is a zero element. So from this, state is ABC, city is Hyderabad, and state is TL. And address of one, that means that from the second element, we will get city, address XYZ is street, city, and state. So now we will able to get the data exactly from the JSON array. So in the statement, especially we have to convert this JSON array into Python list. So once you convert that into Python list, we can iterate the elements, and for each element we can extract the value. So this is how we need to read the JSON data from the JSON file in Python. All right. So that's all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching.